In this video, we're going to look at how to use the MID formula to extract data from inside of a cell in Excel. Now, if you'd like a refresher, I do have another video on the basic use of the left, right, and MID formula that might be good to watch prior to this one. But how we're going to do this is we're going to use another formula inside of the MID formula to help Excel figure out which data to pull. So in this exercise, we have two names, and we just want to pull the last name from this short list. So we're going to do that using MID, and we're going to type equals MID, open parentheses, and our cell number, which in this case is B3. And then now this is where we need to communicate with Excel where to begin. Now, one commonality both of these have is, of course, a space between the first and last name. So we're going to leverage that space. And so the next formula will be, we're going to use search and type in quotation marks, space, and quotation marks again. And we need to let Excel know that that space will be found in cell B3. And now we close that parentheses, and we're going to do a plus one. Now this plus one helps Excel know not to count the space as a character. So it's going to look for the space and then begin bringing back a result in the next position. So plus one, and even though Smith only has five letters, I'm going to actually put in a bigger number. The reason is, even though we only have John Smith and Jane Brown, if our list was longer, I don't want to have to think about how many characters the last name has. So we're just going to type in 10. Close our parentheses, and you see how we have Smith, the full thing. Now, if Smith were longer, like let's say it's Smithsonian, well, actually that's more than 10 characters. So if this was, say, 15, it would bring back the full last name. So this is one way that you can pull information, and if you copy it down, you see that we can use the same formula for Jane Brown. Now, if you leave this plus one out, what'll happen? You'll still get back information, but you see right here how you have a space before Brown. So we don't necessarily want that. It doesn't make for a very clean list. So we like to include the plus one. You can use the find function as well here. It wouldn't really change anything because we're using a space. But just know when you're using them, the main difference between search and find functions is that find is case sensitive where search is not. So it's a little bit more forgiving. And I do have a video that you can watch on those two functions if you'd like to brush up on how to use them. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to give it a like and subscribe to this channel so you can catch all future videos as they come out. Thanks.